Tales from the Crypt presents Bordello of Blood.
You're watching my good fiend, Roger Walker, on Slasher Pepper. Enjoy.
Hey guys, Slasher Pepper, and welcome to another video on the Dr. Pepper Diner. Today, I'm going to be reviewing Bordello of Blood. Another week has passed, another Tuesday is today. So, happy Tales from the Crypt Tuesday, and today we are celebrating Bordello of Blood. Now, Bordello of Blood is quite interesting for me because the first time I saw it, I preferred it over Demon Knight. I always loved Demon Knight, but somehow the first time I watched Bordello of Blood, I thought it was so much fun, and even preferred it over Demon Knight. Now, I rewatched them for these Tales from the Crypt Tuesday reviews, and I've come to the conclusion that I prefer Demon Knight over Bordello of Blood. But yeah, I think that's the most common opinion, actually. Demon Knight over Bordello of Blood. A lot of people tend to prefer Demon Knight, and so do I now. At first I didn't, but let's get started with the review by reading a synopsis from IMDb. The Crypt Keeper returns to tell the story of a funeral parlor that moonlights as a vampire bordello. I'm usually not a big fan of vampire movies, but Fright Night and Bordello of Blood are actually two of my favorite films of all time. So yeah, you heard it there. One of my favorite movies of all time. I love this movie that much. I think it's a very fun story. I think Demon Knight doesn't take itself seriously or anything, but I think this one doesn't take itself seriously at all, actually. It actually starts off with an Indiana Jones type intro, and then you get to the Crypt Keeper, which is a fun twist, and I'm glad they still had the Crypt Keeper, because if they didn't have the Crypt Keeper at all, it wouldn't have worked. Honestly, it would have been a Tales from the Crypt movie. Now, I really love Dennis Miller as Rafe Gutman. He is a really fun character and a hero you definitely root for during the entire film. And Angie Everhart is great as Lilith. She is a great vampire, honestly. Besides Jerry from Friday Night, Lilith is one of my favorite vampires of all time, actually. She's really great. The overall mood and atmosphere, like in the bar and then them going to like this hooker house, is so much fun, and then the fact that they have to get in a coffin, and then there's like this sort of roller coaster thing, and then they get into a bar and stuff. That's so great. I love that concept so much. It's not just your average vampire movie. There's such a cool twist to it, and this is one of the funniest movies I've ever seen. This is one movie that I just can't stop laughing at it because it's so much fun. This movie also stars Corey Feldman, and near the end he's like this really over-the-top vampire, which is really great to see. And did I mention how gory it is? It's pretty damn gory. There's lots of cool gore in here. Near the end you have Ballroom Blitz playing by Sweet, and they're just shooting vampires with water guns, which is something, like, what are a movie as a final, like, the big climactic scene, which is a shootout in a bar with vampires and water guns. Like, no other movie has that. And that's why I love it so much. That's just fucking great. And I'm a big fan of Sweet and the album that has Ballroom Blitz. I've actually listened to that album a lot of times, and I've listened to the song of Ballroom Blitz a ton of times. The song is edited shorter, so it would fit the scene. As a fan of the band and that song, it's kind of distracting. But oh well, you know, I'm not here for to listen to Ballroom Blitz. I'm here to see them shoot up vampires with water pistols, you know? And when I say over the top, it's really over the top. It's like vampires melting in the fucking light. And I love it for that. It's a ton of fun. I wish they had made a third Tales from the Crypt movie. Anyway, Tales from the Crypt Bordello of Blood, I'm gonna give 9 Dr. Peppers out of 10. Cheers, everybody. Have a happy Tales from the Crypt Tuesday. I'll see you guys next time. See ya.
You're pissing me off, Roger.